want to guarantee each person their kid whose life is in harm's way will have the maximum support, will have the best chance to come home alive, and will be backed up to the hilt.
Dear Saddam Hussein, I'm not a politician. I'm not a world leader. I'm not a general or even in the military. But I am an American concerned about what's going on in the world right now, and I don't like what I see. 17 years ago, this country endured a devastating war in Southeast Asia. Now we're being asked to fight another war against you. Well, this is a painful reality we must face, as we have so many times in the past. War is nothing new to this country. We've fought many wars to stop aggression. We did it in World War I, we did it in World War II, and we did it in Korea and Vietnam. Thousands of Americans who gave their lives for something they believed in. The right for people to live their lives without threats or fear hanging over their heads. And through this we have learned there is a price to pay. A sacrifice that is costly for all those involved. Now this may not mean much to you, but it means a great deal to us. Americans don't want war. In fact, we hate war. But we will stand up to you. We are committed. America will do anything within reason to avoid war. But don't mistake kindness for weakness. If you insist on pulling America into your war, remember this. When you look out across the desert sand and you see America's sons and daughters coming straight at you, you can count on one thing for sure, Mr. Hussein. We'll kick your ass all the way back to Baghdad. And that's a promise.